Hey guys, it's Hannah here, and boy, am I excited today! A little bit more than usual, perhaps, because I received a very, very kindly sent package from none other than Artesa, or Artisa, I'm not exactly sure how you're supposed to pronounce it, but I have worked with Artesa before, and I love their products. I do use their Real Brush pens and their watercolor paper. It's like my go-to whenever I want to do some art, when I'm feeling artsy. And I was so happy when they reached out to me again. So thank you so much, the team over at Artesa. And today I have a full-on watercolor haul, which I'm really just intrigued, really, to share with you and experiment, show you a little bit. I'm excited to try it myself based on the descriptions of the items. I think that I will be loving these products just as much as the previous ones. And everything that you will see in this video, plus anything on the Artesa site, you can get for 10% off using my code here. And I already recommend Artesa. I already love their products, and you get so much value for your money. So to get even a little bit of more discount with this code, it's just a great deal. So either way, let's dig in. All right, so first off, I have these really, really tiny miniature brushes, it says. So these are like detail brush, brushes that you can use for all kinds of things. They're supposed to be like mixed media, or you can use it for many different purposes. But I am going to try to use them with watercolor because that's the medium I have. But as you can see, they are super, super tiny. Some of them are just little baby brushes, super cute. And even the biggest one is still quite narrow and thin. So you have a lot of sizes here to do some detail work if you're working on miniature things or just tiny details in artworks or whatever, really. So I'm really excited to try these out. And then I also got these. This is a three pack of, it's super cute, really. These are like miniature watercolor books. This is just so cute. And I have actually wanted to get like a watercolor book. This is me. I prepped a little for the video. I will be trying out the watercolors in here, but I've been wanting to have a watercolor book to really encourage me to draw more or paint more, I mean. Because if you know, I can date it and I can just doodle or you know, paint something, not having it to be like a finished art piece, but just really trying things out, experimenting, and then it's just so easy to have it all, you know, together in this book, and it's easy to look back and see how I've progressed. I think this, for me, this is a great way to be able to, in the future, see my progress over time. And it's also great for traveling because it's so tiny and cute. As you can see, it also comes with a little bookmark as well, which I think is wonderful. So you can just place it wherever you finished so you know where to begin. At the very back, there's also a tiny little pocket where you can put something inside. You can see it actually opens quite wide. So if you have some, I don't know, images or anything you want to take on the go, this is a great book for that. Just super cute. And it was a three pack, so I'm good to go for quite a while, but I really want to encourage myself to actually use it now that I have it. So, yes. Something else really, really exciting. This is a new product of theirs, and I was just so happy when I saw this because I didn't even know that I've been looking for something like this, but when I saw it, I was like, that's perfect. So, this is their blank watercolor cards, and these are on 100% cotton paper, which is really the way to go, I've heard. And I do love their premium watercolor paper that is not cotton. It's 300 GSM, I believe all of their papers are. So, yeah, it's just, I think for me, this is a good way to try the cotton paper because I don't really have experience with that. So, what you get in here, this box is just lovely as well, but you get these cards, and they are foldable, but they are, like they said, on 100% cotton paper. So you have this beautiful card. I don't know exactly what size. It does remind me a little bit of a B6 size, but it says here the size. It's 5 by 6.9 inches. I don't know if this is like, well, 5 by 7. It's almost 5 by 7. So yeah, it's almost a B6 size. So you have this foldable card, and then at the back here, you also receive envelopes for each card. So you have just a blank envelope you can put your finished card in. So it's really a DIY set so that you can paint your own watercolor cards and gift to somebody. I think this is a wonderful idea for like birthdays or even for Christmas or any time really. I already actually do make watercolor cards sometimes and gift to people. Usually a very simple way I do so. I'm still very much a watercolor beginner, but I think this is gonna be a lot more fun now that I actually have this lovely set to work with. So yeah, this is just a really cool product, and it's just so convenient to have it all done, so I don't have to cut down the paper anymore into the right card size and then, you know, get it to fit into another envelope. It's all in here. It's everything I need, except for the watercolor, of course, but I'll get to that. And I also received some more of their premium watercolor paper. I did receive, I think last time, or the first time, I don't exactly remember, these as well. Except this time I decided to go for the A4 sheets. The other ones are a bit bigger. I'll actually show you. So this is the pad I've been working with ever since I received it. So you can see here that the sizing is a bit different. It's a bit wider, almost the same height, but it's a bit wider. I didn't know that they had finished A4 once, but realizing it's much more convenient for me to do A4, because not that I feel like I'm at that level yet, but if I ever were to want to frame something or, I don't know, post it, like send something to someone, everything is based on A4 or A5, the A format here in Sweden, so it's just easier that way. I don't have to cut, because all the time with these I had to cut them. So I think this is wonderful. Now I have finished A4 once. And you can see I've all used quite a bit of this pad here. I've just been loving these papers. But those I've already shown in another Arteza video, but I will try to link it up here. So either way, it's a 2-pack with these. I'm really, really happy to have more paper because I've been going through quite a lot recently. So thank you so much, Arteza. Alrighty, so getting into the thing I might be the very most excited for in this video is their set of watercolors. So it came in this beautiful box. It includes 36 different colors, which is wonderful. And it's a lot of beautiful colors here, as you could see. I love this painting as well. I wish I could paint like that, but practice makes progress. So we will see whenever I get to that. Either way, so it's a big palette. It's a really big palette. And you have these, you could swatch or mix different colors in here, but now when you have so many already, you barely need to mix them, but you can if you want to. So I already opened up most of them here, as you can see. You can see all of them came packaged like this. I wanted to show you just so you get an idea, but it took quite a while to open up every single one, and I didn't really want to do that on camera. I didn't really see the need, but they're really easy to get off just like this. All right, here are all the beautiful colors. As you can see, it's a beautiful range. And from what I've seen and heard, these are really pigmented and just beautiful. This palette also comes with this brush. It's a water brush, so I actually already loaded it up with water so that I'm ready to use it. So I think that's really wonderful. You get everything you need. So really, if I'm traveling or just whatever, I can just bring my little pocket tiny book here And I have the watercolors and the brush already. That's all I need to start creating, which is really, really awesome. So speaking of creating, let's get to that, shall we? All right, so opening up my little book. As you can see, I already made some little circles here. And my idea, I just wanted to swatch some colors, but I wanted to do it with the wet-on-wet technique. Once again, I'm new to watercolors, so I'm not a pro at all. But I'm just gonna squeeze some water into the brush, and we'll see. I will just get some water onto the paper so that we have a wet surface. And then I am going to decide what color do I want to use. I'm gonna start with one of my favorites. I'm gonna go with a magenta or pink one. Ooh, wow. So this is really fun because it kind of floats out like that, which is beautiful. Yeah. All right, so that's cool. I want to, let's see, I'm gonna add some more water to see. I'm not used to this brush exactly. I do have some other water brushes from Artesa. I'm just gonna kind of make it move a little. Then I have some tissue paper over here so I can get the color off because I want to add another color. I am going to take the violet, but just because it's next to it and it looks beautiful as well. Loading it up and then oh, that's so, it's so dark. I took too much. But that's okay. I'm just trying out the colors now, seeing how they work. So I'll just leave it like that and it will have to live and move however it wants to. All right, so I already wetted this circle and now I'm going to take, I do love a bright yellow, so I'm going to take this one at the very top here. And I will just do the same. Oh, I love this color. It's so pretty. And then I am going to take this bright orange. Next, I'm going to take this beautiful, I think this one was called Emerald Green. It's like a really beautiful jewel color. And I am, oh, I love that effect when it just moves away. Look, it just does the work for me. I do, or do I? I'm not sure. I really want to see how this bright green color looks like. I'm not sure if it's gonna look good with the emerald, but I'm gonna try for fun. Next, I am going to take a beautiful blue. I think I'm gonna work with this bright one. Then I am taking, I think actually I want to try this darker one over here and see what that one looks like. Wow, look at these. It's so pretty. Oh, I feel like this one is almost already dry. That was quick. And look at this paper. Look at all these beautiful colors. I also wanted to try out some of these and just do some really tiny details. So I'm just gonna take one of the tiniest, because why not? And see how they work with watercolors. So I am going to just take some water in the brush and place it on this green. And I will get some on the brush. It's so tiny, so super tiny. I'm just gonna, I don't know, do some little somethings. Little stars or something, I don't know. You can really do such tiny work on these. Oh my gosh, look at those tiny little. takes up the color beautifully. So that is just wonderful. Alright guys, so that is everything for this Arteza haul and tryout slash review, whatever you want to call this type of video. Thank you so, so much to the team over at Arteza for sending these all to me. I'm so grateful and I love everything and I'm so excited to try more things out and experiment. And I'm really excited to just learn watercolor more using this gorgeous palette and these really fun books. Once again, if you're interested to try out some of these products yourself, don't forget to use the coupon code so that you can save a little bit. And also, I have links to everything that you've seen in the description below as well. And with that said, I just want to say thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it was helpful or that you enjoyed it. And I hope to see you next time. Bye for now!